important businessman who spends his day doing difficult and important business work. I don't have time to figure out new ways of doing things that should be easy. No, I don't have any time to buy any of your Girl Scout cookies. Can't you see I'm busy with all this important business work? I like Trivia Night Triad because it takes the hassle out of difficult tasks, like understanding the YouTubes, or answering questions about some movie I watched 15 years ago.
All I have to do to play is go to YouTube and search for ThatJonLusk and find the livestream. Then I open the Socrative student website or phone app, put in that room code L971, and I'm in like Flint, baby. The 1967 James Coburn movie, not Flint, Michigan, which still doesn't have access to clean drinking water. There, it's as easy as typing in my answers and submitting them. Trivia Night Triad gives me the freedom to move from question to question, so I can go back and change or enter an answer I might think of later on. You'll notice there are no questions listed on the quiz, as this game runs at the pace of the live stream. Just make sure you're paying attention to what's happening on screen. If I want to play in a team of no more than six people, I just call up whoever I want on my side, discuss the answer before I submit it, because it's totally allowed. You can also use a chat service like Discord. The only thing not allowed is cheating, because cheaters don't really win, and winners don't use drugs, or something. Finally, a live stream trivia game I can watch on my TV set using any YouTube-enabled device, such as a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick. This is the easiest way to play, because I don't have to keep switching between tabs. I don't have time for that window switching kind of stuff after a long, hard day of doing business. I can use my phone, or my laptop, to submit answers while watching the live stream on my HDTV. If I had a regular desktop PC set up in the same room as my television, I could do that too. Well, that's it. It's as easy as 1, 2, trivia. Wait, how did that Girl Scout get into my house?
I don't know what I did,
But it worked! So I don't need the headset now. Oh my god, that was awful. Let me stop this music. Try to get a little hold on what's going on here. Oh my god. I need a drink and stat. Move this down here. Make it a small. Alright, hello, welcome to Trivia Night Triad. Sorry for, I don't know what's going on with this computer. I switched to a different cable that I happened to find when I went upstairs for that headset, and that seems to have worked. I apologize to anybody that missed that one about Stratford Road. Most of the people that are playing trivia are from here, but there's a couple outliers in different areas, so thanks for playing. I will also let you know, I gave the people that said, like, I'm from Wisconsin and I'm from Texas, you got a free point. So if there's anybody else that is playing from out of state or whatever, out of the area, let me know, I'll add you a point back later. Obviously, no cheating, don't look up answers. You are allowed to talk to friends over the phone or like a Discord chat service, as long as they're not looking up the answers. But yeah, that's the only really, the rule is, please don't cheat, it's lame. So yeah. Number one was, whose mascot is that? It is the Wake Forest Demon Deacons logo. Wake Forest University, which is located here in Winston-Salem. Number two, what sport is the Heisman Trophy awarded in? And that is football, college football, to be exact. Number three, what kind of cheese is pictured there? It is Pepper Jack cheese. Pepper Jack. Number four, what is Batman's secret identity? And that is Bruce Wayne. Bruce Wayne. This is Adele right there. Singer Adele. Number six, which war was fought between the northern and southern United States? And that's the Civil War, as we most often refer to it here in the States, the American Civil War. Number seven, what state does the girl in that clip live in? Dorothy from Wizard of Oz, Dorothy Gale, lives in Kansas. Number eight, the name of that outdoor shopping center on Stratford Road is Thruway Shopping Center. Thruway Shopping Center. Number nine, who are the two famous Walt Disney chipmunks? And that's Chip and Dale. Chip and Dale. Number 10, who's the band or artist? It was Weezer. Weezer. Alright, and I will also let you know, we don't have a sponsor tonight, so I don't have any gift cards to give out at the end of tonight's game. I hope you stick around anyway, just for the fun of it. I might scrounge up something from, like, my prize box from when I absconded with Hutch and Harris's prizes when we went out of business. But anyway, please don't look up answers, though. That's the only thing I really ask of you. But let's go on to round two, and then I'm going to go grab a beer in a second. What character did this actor most famously play on television? Again, what actor did this character most famously play on television? Do you lose a point if you guess the wrong answer? No, you do not lose a point if you guess the wrong answer, unless I say explicitly that that's the case. Usually that's only if, like, it's like people are tied in every round, I might add that. Number two, which is, what is the hardest naturally occurring substance on Earth? Number three. Ah, as I could enjoy this nice Corona beer, because I saw Corona Factor is playing, and I was like, you know what, I'll have a little Corona Factor myself, as long as it doesn't have a twist of virus in it. Number three, who is this statue of? Who's that statue? That's number three, tonight's second round. So much nicer to be able to talk to you guys, and not have to, like, try and type out everything, because that is a mess. I'm really glad that that's over. Number four, what does SCOTUS mean? What does SCOTUS mean? That's hilarious. Apparently when the camera came on, it scared somebody. Number five is a movie clip. I think it has a language warning on it, possibly. Although, if you could have heard the language that I was using when the camera wasn't working, I would have been banned from YouTube. Here's that clip for number five in round two.
Is that it? One more! One more! Grand Edition! Grand Edition! Oh. Garland Green! Garland Green!
Should be interesting. Should be interesting.
What the fuck is that? some people up and down the eastern seaboard. The way he killed those people makes the Manson family look like the Butcher's family.
Well, he's on the right track. He's on the right track.
Number six is, what planet is Superman from? What planet is Superman from? And allegedly, each round should get a little more difficult. This one's still pretty easy from what I can tell, but I'm pretty sure the next two, it ramps up a bit. If it doesn't, I always have a little bit of tiebreak on the side, ready for emergencies. Number seven. Whose logo is this? Whose logo is on the screen? Thank you for telling me that that is echoing. My monitor is on, and now that the camera is on, you can hear it. Earlier, I was like, well, it doesn't matter. Nobody can see or hear me. So I was like, I'll just turn my sound up. No, I'm so sorry about that. Number eight is, what is the capital of Tennessee? What is the state capital? State of Tennessee. Number nine is multiple points. Please only put right answers. but I'm not going to count off for wrong answers yet, I don't think. Which Walt Disney characters carry an umbrella with them? Again, which Walt Disney characters carry an umbrella with them? Number 10 is going to be, who's that band or artist? Who's that band or artist? Good luck. Alright, so we're going to go over round two. Number one in round two was, what character did that actor, Alfonso Ribeiro, most famously play on television? And that is Carlton Banks. Carlton Banks from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Number two, what is the hardest naturally occurring substance on Earth? And that is diamonds. Diamond. Number three, who is that statue of? It is Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan. Number four, what is SCOTUS? It is the Supreme Court of the United States. The Supreme Court of the United States. Number five, what movie's in the clip? And that was Con Air. Con Air, the Nicolas Cage film. Number six, what planet is Superman from? Krypton. Krypton. Number seven, that is the logo for Snapchat. Snapchat. Number eight, capital of Tennessee is Nashville. Nashville. Number nine, which Walt Disney characters carry an umbrella with them? And the answers that I accepted for now, unless I'm going to try and see to corroborate one of these answers, the answers I accepted were Mary Poppins, Jiminy Cricket, Jane from Tarzan, which I didn't know about, but I googled it and that is true, and then the White Rabbit from Alice in Wonderland. Scrooge McDuck does not carry an umbrella, he carries a cane. And the driver from Lady and the Tramp, I'm trying to find out. I don't remember that in the animated one, but it's possible. And I'll look that up between the round. Alright. Number 10. Who's the band or artist? And that was Buddy Holly, because the Weezer song was Buddy Holly, and it was like next up in Spotify, and I was like, yeah, let's just do that. So Buddy Holly was the answer to that. That is it for second round. At the end of it, let me pull up my score sheet. And I wanted to give a shout out. There's apparently a team playing from South Beach who their friends or family plays at Old Nick's, and they're playing, and they thanked me for doing this, and I appreciate you coming. I hope you're having a good time. We're going to go into the next round. Hopefully it's going to get a little more difficult, maybe split these ties a little more. Round three. Number one. What was the name of the gentleman and the princess bride whose father was killed? Again, what was the name... the gentleman in Princess Bride whose father was killed. He was seeking revenge. And that is number one. I'm going to look up this Lady and the Tramp thing. I don't think... I think I'm going to go against that. Because that's pretty stretching to be like, hey, this guy who shows up in one scene and he drives a taxi. He was like, oh, I carry an umbrella. I can't take that. I'm sorry. Sorry. If it was like... the dad or mom of Lady, maybe. Speaking of Lady, I'll bring her over here in a little bit. We're going on to round three, number two. Who is pictured there? Who's pictured in that photo, number two? Number three. is, who is the current U.S. Attorney General? And who is the current U.S. Attorney General? Number four tonight in the third round is, what movie is in the clip? Question is, what's the movie clip? You thought that when I said clip, I was going to start the clip. You were wrong. Now I'm starting the clip.
Okay, class, let's hear what these results are.
If my calculations are correct, this will create ice. Oh no! Killer monster death!
What'd you say? Oh. You're talking to me all wrong. It's the wrong tone. You do it again, I'll stab you in the face with a soldering iron. Is that right? Let me ask you something. Eh? Does your mother sew? Boom! Get her to sew that!
Whoa! Number five is, on the periodic table, which element has an atomic weight of 1.00794? Again, on the periodic table, what element has an atomic weight of 1.0094 grams? I think it's grams. I was like, I realize I don't have whatever the unit of measure it is. I'm pretty sure it's grams. I'm looking up to see if it's grams. Oh my god, that makes me feel so stupid that I'm not, like, automatically like, oh, I know it's this. I'm pretty sure it's grams. Somebody back me up in the chat there. It's not grams. Number six. What is the name of this actor? What is the name of this actor he is pictured on the screen? Moving on to number seven in third round. Why do I keep looking? I have a second monitor. I should be looking at this one. What is on the New Belgium logo? What is on the New Belgium beer logo? This is going about 90 times more smoothly than it was at 7:30. So I'm okay right now. This is good. Oh my god, that was a nightmare. I don't know why they did that. It's like the first 2 days, cool. Second night, problem. Or third night, problems. Tonight, it was crazy, but we fixed it, and I'm gonna test it out like 30 or 45 minutes before trivia starts next time. Number eight is, who's the artist of that painting? Who is the artist of the painting on the screen? Number nine is, which states border the Chesapeake Bay? It is a multiple point question. Which states border the Chesapeake Bay? If you put a wrong answer, this time it's a minus point, so it will count off your other answer. If you have answers that are correct and you put a wrong one, this is counteracting. It's like that you didn't even answer anything or something. I don't know. And number 10 is, who's this banner artist? Who's this banner artist? Here's your clip. I mean, you're not clip. Your slide with all the song. God, wow, I'm like really twisting my words. Your slide with all of the questions is on the screen. And your question for number 10 is, who is this band or artist? Good luck.
Give me the slip. You know I'm not.
Name of the guy, Inigo Montoya. Number two, Ricky Fowler is the answer. Had a lot of really great ones in that one. I don't know if you heard that over the music, but people said like Aaron Carter, Leonardo DiCaprio, Justin Bieber, a really big Clemson Tigers fan. It's Ricky Fowler, a golfer. Number three, who is the current U.S. Attorney General? And that is William Barr. Number four, what movie's in the clip? The Adventures of Joe Dirt. Joe Dirt. Number five, periodic table element with atomic weight of 1.00794 is hydrogen. Hydrogen is the first element on the table. Number six, what is the name of that actor? It's Ricardo Montalban. Ricardo Montalban. He was in Star Trek, The Wrath of Khan. He's also in The Man with the Golden Gun and other things. Oh yeah, I forgot. I keep forgetting I have a second monitor now. Number seven, what is on the new Belgium logo? It's a bicycle. Bicycle. Perhaps with a flat tire, because they have fat tire. I don't know. Number eight, who's the artist of that painting? It is Salvador Dali. Salvador Dali. And I'm going to taste this beer and let you know how it is. Wow, that is really good. I'd heard this was really good. It's pretty amazing. It's a double IPA, and it is smooth. Number nine, which states, I'm not sponsored by that brewery, number nine, although I would, is which states border the Chesapeake Bay? Unfortunately for a lot of players, I had to cancel out some of their answers, because the only two states that it borders is Maryland and Virginia. I've looked at Google Maps extensively where the border is. It cuts off so that the rest is facing the Atlantic Ocean, whatever bay is above that I can't remember the name of, but is just Maryland and Virginia. Number 10 is, who's the band or artist? That bassist, the beer, somebody just asked what's the beer. It's a collaboration called Blaze and Dash from the Incendiary Brewery and some other brewery that they collaborated with. I don't know who HB is, but it's that brewery. But anyway, number 10 again, who's the band or artist? Fountains of Wayne, their bassist, Adam Schlesinger, died from coronavirus yesterday. So, that sucks. That's why they're on there on trivia tonight. And we're going to the double points round, where the points are doubled. Number one is, what's the movie in the clip? Got a movie clip. And that movie clip's coming up. Here it is. What's this movie?
Choice and now my chance is over. I thought I was in. You put me down and say I'm going nowhere. Save me, darling. I am down, but I am far from over. Give me something. I need it all, 'cause I am running over.
Number two is, what type of gas are most light bulbs filled with? Again, what type of gas are most light bulbs filled with? Number three, you've seen him on my my posts. Question is, what is the name of this character? What is this character's name? It's number three. He's my boy. Number four, what holiday was formerly known as Armistice Day? Again, what holiday was formerly known as Armistice Day? Number five, in the final round tonight, worth double the points, is who is this actress? What's the name of the actress that's on the screen? Number six, what Major League Baseball team is tied for most all-time wins in a season, yet is still the only team to never appear in a World Series? Again, what Major League Baseball team is tied for the most all-time wins in one season, but they're the only team that has never been in a World Series, including that year, obviously. Number seven, What is the name of this character? Again, what's the name of this character? Number 8. What's the name of the main character in 2001 A Space Odyssey? Again, what was the name of the main character in 2001 A Space Odyssey? And in case of tiebreak, you might need both names. We'll see. His first and last, I mean. If you have not already done so, I think maybe, like, here, there's a subscribe button. Like, right there, maybe? I don't know. But if you could subscribe to my channel, that'd be awesome. You'll get a reminder every time I'm doing a live stream, like right now. And anytime I post a new video, like I did the other day, featuring my dog, Lady. Oh, crap, I didn't bring her to see you. I'm going to go grab her real quick. If she's out. If she's not. Lady, come here. If you've not met Lady, this is Lady. Like Lady in the Tramp, which somebody put in an answer earlier and I didn't accept. So sorry to you. But she's my little girl, and she's darling, and she's in that video on my channel that we showed at the beginning of tonight. So, number 9, it's worth 2 points. I think it's one of the easier ones in this round. It is, do you know what they call a quarter pounder with cheese in Paris? Also, do you know what this question is a reference to? It's worth 2 points. Again, what do they call a quarter pounder with cheese in Paris? And also, what is this question a reference to? It's worth 2 points. Number 10 is, who's this band or artist? Who's this band or artist? Final round. Hopefully I remember some of these funny answers this time. Also, apparently that family that's playing in South Beach is playing with part of their family in Texas and somewhere else too. Oh, and then the old Knicks people, obviously. So that's really cool. And I love to see that people are being able to play with their families across the nation like this. Last week on the Nerd Trivia Night, we had somebody playing in Japan and the UK, which is crazy. To be on 3 continents playing the same game. And it's really cool. There's a little more. Oh shit, I left the music on again. I'm sorry. But anyway, it's so cool that people are playing from everywhere together and that I can still do this trivia thing. I'm getting a little bit smoother on it each time, save for the camera mishap today, which I'm gonna figure out what's going on. But let's go over the answers to round 4. Number 1 was what movie was in the clip, and that first movie clip, I already forgot again, it was the movie Staying Alive. We had a lot of really close answers there, Flashdance, no, but Saturday Night Fever and Perfect both star John Travolta, and they both do that kind of thing. Staying Alive is actually the sequel to Saturday Night Fever, and it was actually directed by Sylvester Stallone. Number 2. Was what kind of gas typically fills most light bulbs? That is the gas argon. Number 3. What is the name of that character? He's on my tip jar and other like imagery because I think he's hilarious. His name is Tom Nook. He is a raccoon, obviously. And he's from Animal Crossing, which I don't really play, but I really love Tom Nook and KK Slider. They're both really cool, so I kind of want to get that Switch limited edition, but it's like sold out everywhere. What holiday was formerly known as Armistice Day, and that is Veterans Day. Number 5. Who's that actress? She was in a lot of Mel Brooks movies. Her name is Madeline Kahn. She's also in Clue. Why am I itching so bad? She's in Clue, the movie Clue. A bunch of Mel Brooks movies like History of the World Part 1. And I'm pretty sure she's in a few of them. Number 6. What Major League Baseball team is tied for most all-time wins in a season, yet is the only team to never appear in a World Series? And I say to the teams that put the Expos and the Nationals, you fools! That's the team that won last year! That's my team! So it's not them, and they definitely have never tied for most wins in a season of ever any season. So it is not the Expos, the Nationals, which is the same team. They just changed names and locations. It is, in fact, the Seattle Mariners. The Seattle Mariners. Ken Griffey Jr. played on for a long time. What is the name of that character? He is the cool one, obviously, because he wears sunglasses. His name is Finn. Finn. Like a Finn. I am really sorry that I could not accept HAL 9000 as an answer, because I did also, mention that he had a last name. 9000 is not the last name of a computer. And B, this guy survives to the end of the movie, although I like the person that said the obelisk and HAL were the main characters. But, yeah, it is Dave Bowman. Dave Bowman. He is the main astronaut character. He's in, like, the majority of the movie and lives till the end. HAL is not the main character! 9000 is not a last name! It is, in fact, a model number, so I'm sorry, you two. Number 9. You know what they call a quarter pounder with cheese in Paris? A royale with cheese. And that is a reference to Pulp Fiction. I was like reading the comments down here and thinking, Space Odyssey. It was a reference to 2001. HAL orders one from the mothership in Jupiter. it is a royale with cheese and Pulp Fiction. Number 10. Who's that band or artist? And that band or artist was Debbie Gibson. We got a lot of Tiffany answers. They're kind of in like a feud. Your mother's maiden name was 9000. Oh my god. that's a great comment. That is it for tonight's game. I don't remember if it's... I didn't even look to see if it was tied. Let's find out together by me calling out from my spreadsheet. It says that the winners tonight, starting from the bottom, we got 18 points going to John Lusk. I placed last, apparently, despite hosting the game. We got 19 points to Ice Bear. We got 28 points going to We Need Matt. I thought, Matt keeps texting me like he's playing. What is happening? Oh, he's on the Space Juice team. That's what's happening. I see. 29 points to Corona Factor, who mysteriously did not play round 4. I don't know what happened there, because I assumed that they would finish the game. So they may have been watching and had a problem with the website. I'm not sure. Let's see. 30 points going to Carol Baskin, you bitch. I've not watched the Tiger King show. I probably won't, because like every time something is insanely popular on Netflix, I'm like, well, I'm not going to watch that now. I'm not going to be that guy that watches what everybody else... I don't care. 38 points going to Double Take. 39 points going to Lone Star Rangers. I missed one team with 35 points. Right behind them was South Beach, or actually two teams behind them was South Beach Freaks. You guys have 35. We got going on to the 40s now. Let's see, 41. 41 going to Space Juice Electric Boogaloo. Maybe if you had collaborated with We Need Matt, you would have done better. With put some respect on the name Space Juice. We got 44 points. There's two teams. Is there? Yes. Mark and Courtney. And we just might get lucky. I will also say, Courtney, my auto spell check is saying your name is spelled wrong. let's see. 45 points. No, 45 points. Yes, 45 points to Alan.
Alan got 45. We got 46. Going to Velociraptors. Velociraptors. We got 47 points going to Team Spalding. 48 points going to Team Name Here. I'm making sure I didn't miss anybody. I can't remember if I said this. 44 points. We just might get lucky. I feel like even at regular trivia, I always somehow leave out your score. So I figured I'd say it again just in case I did it today. 44 points till we might just get lucky. Let's see. 49 points. Not happening. Oh, we have 52 points to our second place tonight. And that team... Wait, hold on. I'm going to make sure I didn't say anybody's name wrong. I didn't call out somebody's score. Cray K, 47 points. I'm just going back over the 40s. Okay, that's it. Okay. So, we have 52 points going to our second place team tonight. That team is Tommy and Tammy. We have, with 56 points, getting the band back together. I don't know who you are, but you gotta let me know. Because I might give you a prize. 56 points, getting the band back together. Thank you guys all for playing tonight. I do this during the hiatus. I'm doing this on Tuesdays and Thursday nights at 7:30. That's today. So I'll be doing it again Tuesday. Also, it looks like I got two people that said Sundays work best. So I'm going to do nerdy trivia on Sunday, probably at 6 o'clock. So that is Sunday night, 6 o'clock, we'll do nerdy trivia. Unless I say differently, I will find out what your prize is, sir. Let's see. Actually... Kevin, how many people are playing on your team? That's what I need to know, because I'll have to go dig up some prizes. Nerdy Trivia, Sunday night, 6 p.m., allegedly. If you don't already like this channel and subscribe to this channel, please subscribe to this channel. Like the video. It's probably over here somewhere. Facebook, I have a page called Trivia Night Triad, it's got this... No, it doesn't have the bear on it. It has the cat on it that I'll put on the screen now. Trivia Night Triad. It is this cat... that looks like this. If you go to Trivia Night Triad's Facebook page, like that page, I post every time that I'm doing an event, and sometimes I post hints and stuff, or like crazy whatever. So go like that page, show up soon please, and if you are feeling tipsy like I'm about to be after I finish this beer, I've got a tip jar. I appreciate every tip that goes in that, because I currently am earning $0 because I lost my job because it takes place in bars and restaurants. But I appreciate it, and thank you to everybody that's already tipped me, and I appreciate everything that you guys send. And I'm glad that I get to spend this time with you, and it gives me something to do. I hope you had fun, and I hope to see you again soon. Please have a good night, and till then.
Da-ba-da-ba, da-ba-da-ba. I'm so in love with you, I wanna wad you up into my life. Let's roll up to be a single star in the sky. I need you to feel me, I wanna wad you up into my life. Let's love up to make a single star in the sky to you.
Da ba 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 da